Hi all, Angular 15.1 has been released. So in this version they have introduced a feature called self-closing tags. So this feature is already available in other frameworks like React. So what do you mean by a self-closing tag? So as you know, the different tags which are available in HTML. So most of the tags have a opening and a closing syntax, but certain tags like the break, that is the line break, these tags are self-closing, that is they do not have an opening and a closing tag. As of Angular 15.1, what they have done is they have made most of the Angular component tags, that is the custom selectors which we create for a Angular component. So in this case we have a app component which has the selector defined as app root. So normally we will be giving this syntax for defining that particular component in the HTML. But as of the latest version, we can create this as a self-closing tag. So we do not need the closing tag. And this syntax will work fine. So when we run our application, you can see in the network that we are receiving the self-closing tag, but when we open that in the elements, you can see that it has been properly translated in the DOM. Almost all Angular components will be having the self-closing tag as selectors, except the components which make use of content projection. Since these components need to have inner content which needs to be projected using the ng content, they will still need to have an opening and closing tag. The self-closing tags have also been introduced for the Angular elements, which is a feature in Angular which is used for creating custom elements within our application. Let's get started on the Angular elements. So first we need to add the Angular elements in the package.json. So here, let's add the package. So once we have installed the package, we can go to the app module and remove the bootstrap. And then let's add the ng do bootstrap lifecycle hook, within which what we will be doing is we will be creating a custom element. And the custom element selector will be the app element. So once we imported all the dependencies, we will be creating the custom element. Now we can copy the selector of this custom element to the index.html and access it as a self-closing tag. So now when we go to our application, you can see that the custom element is getting rendered properly and the self-closing tag is supported for these custom elements as well. So what are your thoughts about this new feature which is introduced in Angular 15.1? Let me know in the comments. See you soon. Thank you.